1 minute. I'll ask you just one simple question, okay? How many press conferences and how many senior leaders and how many times have your top leaders, including Mr. Narendra Modi, taken a position on the alleged issue of gold plating by Reliance in the KG-D6 issue? How many times and how many leaders have done that? Why don't you just tell us now? How many times have your party leaders had press conferences on the alleged defrauding, alleged, and consider the observations made by the Supreme Court at various cases ever since the legal battle between SEBI and Sahara began in 2011? Haven't you read it? You don't know about it, or you pretend not to know?
So what is Medha Patkar saying?
When it comes to big corporates, you don't have the spine.
Common people which was invested in these OFCD should be refunded right away.
Oh, really?
Medha Patkar, the order of the Supreme Court of India.
Medha Patkar, you're satisfied with that? You think it answers the question?
No. I think I didn't hear the answer clearly enough. Can you repeat?
No. When it is not convenient for them to hear, they lose the voice and everything starts happening to them. Please again reiterate that 372 crores of public money was given to Reliance Group by the Aam Aadmi Party. Then you should respond if you can hear me.
By the Aam Aadmi Party?
He alleges...
Let the Aam Aadmi Party...
You were in power in Delhi.
...respond to this and we will. And...
I thought you were going to contest on Aam Aadmi Party ticket, madam.
Pardon me?
This is very remarkable.
One minute. First of all, Aman, I fear tonight that what you are doing is that you are avoiding the questions on Subrata Roy.
Reply to this.
You want to reply? Go ahead.
Anybody who does not abide by the rule of law has to face the consequences. And Mr. Subrata Roy should also face the consequences whatever violations of law or of the Supreme Court order that he has done.
So you take action, please. You take action. Let BJP take action
squandering away all the public money and then you'll Adani. Start
let Congress
that
take
you take
position
action.
On Ambani. And let... Of course, because I have given you a specific instance
where the Aam Aadmi Party government has given away 372 crores of public money to these private discoms owned by Reliance Group. What do you have to say about
that? Your party...
Apart from making all the wild sweeping allegations...
Aman Sinha, are you avoiding a question on Subrata Roy because you have spoken in favor of your party's prime ministerial candidate?
You are a candidate of the party.
Aman Sinha, 1 minute.
You're
representing your party. Aman Sinha, don't have a private conversation there with Medha Patkar, please, if you allow me. Now, I think that
I'm
the BJP...
I'm not the representative of the party.
One minute, please. You see, look at the BJP spokesperson's very intelligent strategy. He realizes he has no answer on the case of Subrata Roy. He also realizes that it is absolutely true that his party has not committed itself on Subrata Roy. So I ask him a question.
That Mr. Subrata Roy has to face consequences of all his actions and omissions that he's made.
That's the kind of blasé reply that you can use to describe anything. If I talk to you about why did climate change happen in the Jurassic era, you can use the same answer to reply there. That's no answer. The fact of the matter is
No, absolutely not. I'll give you a different answer.
The fact of the matter is this. My question to you was, you put a political spin in the case of the NSEL scam. You put a political spin in the case of the CWG scam, in the case of the 2G scam. In this case, you are completely and embarrassingly silent. And the question is simple, that the BJP lacks the spine to take a position when it comes to Reliance. When it comes to KGD6 basin, the BJP lacks the spine when it comes to Sahara. And I have not seen any press conference by top BJP leaders, either on the issue of alleged gold plating in the KGD6 basin or in the case of Sahara. Somewhere, all the outrage which you feel when you felt in the case of CWG or Railgate evaporates when it comes to these two cases. So hear it fair and clear, Mr. Aman Sinha. Don't think the people of this country are foolish,
or that
the media of this country will not ask questions. Before I go back to Sudhindra Bhadauria, Lord Meghnath Desai, yes, please.
No, absolutely.
Lord Meghnath Desai.
Please allow me to respond now.
Lord Meghnath Desai, let's return to the debate. Lord Meghnath Desai. Lord Meghnath Desai, please.
The real scandal is...
Lord Desai is replying.
Just 1 minute.
Lord Desai is replying.
The real scandal is...
I'm just saying that all these cases of corruption...
The real scandal is...
Desai, please, can we have his volume up and the other one down?
Just shut up. Just shut that man up. Shut that man up. The real scandal is... real scandal is...
1 minute, sir.
Real scandal is that many, many small investors' money has been embezzled, and these political parties have never spoken up for small investors, neither Mamata Banerjee in the chit fund case, nor these people in the Sahara case. And this scandal has been going on for years. And it took SEBI to catch
this. We have spoken.
Where was the government? Where was the Reserve Bank of India?
Cannot be leveled against BJP.
And none of these people, we had to wait till the SEBI got the Supreme Court into the act. So small investors have been cheated because political parties are only interested in big money.
Well said. Let's get the BSP in.
Allegation could be directed
towards
BSP
Congress,
in. But BJP.
My question
BJP
is,
let's get the Aman
Sinha, 1 minute,
all questions
please,
about these scams
please
that
come
he's
in
mentioning.
When, please come in. Just wait a minute. Now, Mr. Sudhindra Bhadauria,
sure.
Is it true?
Oh, do shut up.
Is it true that there was a private deal?
Please, Mr. Desai, mind your language. You know, if you know, you must, you know, considering your age,
I
if people
do
give
shut
you respect,
up.
You shouldn't respond in this manner.
Do shut
okay,
up,
okay.
Sir.
So you also please
sir,
do shut up.
Do shut up. Sir.
Please do shut up,
honored,
sir.
Honored leader of the BJP.
Oh my God, what is this debate
yeah.
going on?
Honorable honored
sir.
Leader of the BJP. Mahashay.
Okay, General.
Okay.
Acha, theek hai. Acha, okay. Wonderful. Okay,
thank
now here's the question.
Much,
the other question is.
I think we should be watchful of our language at least.
Okay, okay, okay. That's I the Samajwadi Party always likes to take a high moral ground. Now, I want the truth out of this program.
It's not about high moral
Lord
ground.
This I was
you
saying.
Might,
on the,
you might
on
disagree
the,
with
on
us,
the six...
but that does not mean you start calling people by name.
Okay, fine. But I'll just tell you one thing, that a few days back, There were two politicians who on the floor of the UP assembly took out their shirts and stripped. Then a cabinet minister who's your party colleague was seen in pictures telling those MLAs that why don't you take off your clothes under the waist as well. And then later he spoke about it. He said they did not reflect their manhood. If they took off their clothes, we would have known about that as well. So you know what? This whole business about... talking well.
Are you inspired by the parliament or the assembly?
Well,
I think we should set an example, Arnab.
I'm shocked by both, Gaurav.
Yes, we should set an example.
I'm shocked by both.
Even in our differences, we can be civilized.
Did you tell Azam Khan to mind his language? Anyway, let's not go astray. My question,
Arnab, I would always stick to the basic principles of debating.
We are getting distracted. Let's go back. I agree with you, Sudhindra Bhadauria. What exactly is the relationship between the BSP and Sahara?
Well, as far as the Sahara Shri Subrat Roy is concerned, the entire UP, particularly from Gorakhpur to Noida and across the country, knows the meteoric rise of Sahara Shri and Shri Mulayam Singh Yadav. When he became the
what
chief
are you
minister
alleging?
First time in 1989, have started together. Let me just, you've given me a time after 30 minutes, just let me finish it off in 1 minute. Their meteoric rise and the chit fund was a cheat fund, C-H-E-A-T, cheat fund. It was not a cheat fund. The small investors' money was taken from one place to the other, and the false dreams were sold to the people about housing, about small things that would go to these small consumers living in countryside, living in small towns. And that entire money was used for the lavish lifestyle of some people, for the politics of some families, and that is what is the result when Supreme Court has to intervene. And we have seen that he's saying that he wanted to be with his mother, but people, ma means mulayam, not the mother, because when the police went there, he was not there.
So if you
he was
say that, then I would
else's
say
house.
Mayawati so has been in power for four occasions. So then Mayawati also was giving patronage to him?
Yes, most certainly.
Why are you silent on that?
Could have,
don't
could
take...
Have
no, not at all.
I would
on
only
the contrary,
say this.
On
Mayawati
contrary,
was in power four action, times during
the
this tenure.
She,
so then Mayawati was giving... Was patronizing him?
Arnab Goswami...
Do you have an answer
Mayawati
to that?
Mayawati was the chief minister. That
yes.
was the only time... That
yes.
was the only time when action
four
was
times.
Taken.
How Police did he prosper when
action.
Mayawati was
and
in power
you,
four times?
Due process, due process.
Why didn't
because
you take
law,
action if you think that he was cheating on people?
Due process had to be followed all the time.
One minute.
Really?
Gentlemen, I come
and
on.
Today
let me come in between
due process of law.
No, 1 minute. One minute. Both of you keep quiet for a minute. Just 1 minute. Just 1 minute.
I would only request.
I have a follow-up question.
Don't take any names without any substance.
Don't get touchy.
Yes.
Don't get touchy. Just
please don't take any leader's name. I object to that. You want to have a debate with me? You have a debate with me with some substance.
Gaurav Bhatia, 1 minute. Gaurav, you know, first of all, let everyone have their say, right? Yeah.
No, but then if he's taking my leader's name, why would I not interrupt? I never took any leader's name. Let's have a debate that is
what,
at least civilized and is backed by substance.
Where
is the substance he's making?
And he's
making wild allegations. And I'm supposed to hear those?
Is it unconstitutional to take
it
your leader's name?
It is not a wild
name?
Allegation. All the time, Sahara is with Mulayam and Mulayam is with Sahara. That the whole country knows.
I asked you a question, Mr. Bhadauria. You didn't answer that.
1 minute.
I asked you four times Mayawati was the chief minister. Was she patronizing him?
No, Gaurav.
Why don't you answer that?
Gaurav, by saying which
not
you are making
all.
A big admission.
Not the least. In fact, whatever
no,
action
I am not.
Was taken,
Arnab,
it was during her
is,
regime.
I have replied. I've replied to your question,
Gaurav,
Arnab, that
very,
how the state
very,
government acted
you,
fairly.
You've made a very suspicious yes. remark. I'm sorry, but you have made a remark that
not
is
at all because
in
if Gaurav, Mr. Bhadauria makes
complete,
an allegation,
please, you know, Gaurav,
then this is my counter
please
question
let me
to
complete
him.
What I'm saying with respect to you. The question tonight is this: anybody watching the news hour will say that here is the Samajwadi spokesperson who has just admitted on national television that if you have to
not
prosper,
at all.
If you have to
not at all.
I have not even said what
if you give me
you
1 minute, I will tell
no,
you,
I won't give you
how
a
I can show that the state government acted in a fair manner.
And I believe,
I'll give you 5 points.
I believe that, Gaurav Bhatia, you are resorting to a very devious but transparent strategy. When the tough question is put, you stop me from speaking. So, Gaurav, I'll say this to you. My question is this.
Certain facts.
My question
five
is, gentlemen, you don't want facts. I'll tell you what the fact is. Now, I will share a very uncomfortable fact with these two gentlemen on the screen, right? I didn't
please
want
share.
To do it, but
please
I'll
share.
Do it now. Okay? Now,
no,
I have some
do.
Information
tell
tonight
me.
I want to share
yes.
with the viewers. My information is that both
yes.
Samajwadi and BSP equally locked in with Sahara. Now, this is what some people say. Yeah? And by the way, the allegations that you make tonight, Mr. Sudhindra Bhadauria, made with your knowledge, okay? They don't carry my approval. The case is in the Supreme Court. We respect the Supreme Court
yeah.
of India. They will decide eventually. Question is this.
Yeah.
On the 4th of June 2008, when Mayawati was in power, right, the UP government sent a letter to the Reserve Bank of India asking for stringent action against the Sahara India Financial Corporation in a matter related to the security of deposits of investors. Is it true that you were going to take this strong action? Mr. Bhadauria, you are aware of this? Yes or no?
Well, I have said that.
Yes or no.
Was taken was
so far, have I said
time.
Anything incorrect? So far, have I said anything
I have already said that. I have answered your question before you had raised this question in.
Yeah.